Hi, Melissa. Today is Monday the 30th, and it is 2:41 in the afternoon. Okay. I went and I took the glue off of the edges last night when it was real soft. It's really easy to do when it's like that. So we are about to clean it, and we are going to give it its first... its first bit of letting. It takes about three times to do this, so you'll be getting three videos regarding me doing this. All right. Okay, let's get the marker off first. That's that. Okay. All right. All the fingerprints and oils and from all the handling I've done. And you could see from the videos my hands were all over this thing, so. Spins pretty nice. All right. I'm knocking all the air bubbles out. I don't know that there's air bubbles in here, but I know there's air bubbles in here. Nothing's quite as annoying as when you're letting it and you got a nice bead going and all of a sudden it splats. It goes like that and then it sprays. Then you got to clean it up and then start over. And this stuff isn't exactly easy to clean up, so get the bubbles out. This is top and bottom, so no, this is no. This is all right. Not that it matters, but I like to keep it the same way. All right, let's get everything out of the way. All right, we're ready. Another reason I do this in stages is because the more you handle this stuff, the more it will, like, relax. And when I say relax, okay, you want a nice tall bead. The more you handle it, the more it flattens out and spreads wide. You don't want that. So, how you do that is you just do it in stages. Oh yeah, and this is the stuff. It comes in all different colors, and it comes in all different colors, styles, and matte and gloss, and I like gloss. But I'll take what I can get. I mean, it's gonna gloss anyway because I'm gonna varnish it at the end. Bottle's giving me trouble. I don't know why. Canadian air bubble poppet. This is also going to make it a lot stronger too. I mean, it was already strong as it was, but this is like an extra layer of, it's a word I'm looking for, reinforcement, I guess. Paper.